One Horse Town Nerd, overnight success. Sharon Hornells from here with What's She Up To Now, documenting my journey as I transition from the brick and mortar world of business and corporate America, real businesses, I call them real businesses, which irritates my internet friends, by the way, real businesses, to the online world. A couple of years ago, as part of my divorce, we needed to, my ex-husband and I, divest ourselves of all of our joint businesses and joint investments and properties and things. And I found myself old enough to not want to go do the traditional things anymore, but too young to just not do anything and to retire and to just, you know, throw in the towel, literally throw in the towel and do nothing. So I decided, I'd always been interested in the internet and I dabbled, but I really never had time to do much online and explore the internet. You know, back in the beginning, we wondered if the internet was going to even survive. It was going to be a real thing. I remember a lot of things. I remember the year 2000, the Y2K scare, and all these things that we wondered, will the internet survive? Will it really be around? Well, of course, because we human beings are so ingenuic and so amazing, we always figure things out. Nerd comes from our challenge today for the fun challenge. Day, I think, 200, well, let me look. Day 255 of the 365-day Do One Fun Thing Every Day challenge. Started doing that a couple of years ago. I started doing a daily challenge for a year to make myself do video, to make myself show up every day and do something versus making excuses and be scared and not do it. It started with a 365-day Do One Thing Every Day That Scares You challenge, which was a way of stretching and getting out of my comfort zone, which doing video definitely was at that time. Now, I just pretty much do them every day. What you see is what you get. So I started out with that. Then I went, last year was all about happy because I wanted more happiness in my life. I've been through a whole lot, and some of it I share, some of it I haven't. But over time, if you listen to me long enough, you hear pretty much all of the good, the bad, and the ugly. And so I decided that I was moving. I was, you know, finally separating out all the divorce stuff. I was having some physical challenges. I'm like, I need to find some way to bring more happiness into my life. So then I did a 365-day challenge to do one thing that made me happy every single day. And then this year, I decided that I wanted more fun in my life because I, according to my children, was getting pretty boring and pretty stoic and pretty routine and acting old. And so they didn't want that. So I said, okay, this year I'll do one fun thing every day. And it turned out to be the perfect thing because of COVID-19, the Chinese virus. I don't like to call it Corona because I feel really bad for Corona beer and the whole Corona name. I think it's really devastated a company and organization. It's devastated a lot of industries and organizations and companies and businesses. That is sad. It's also created a whole lot more as well. But I don't like to call it the coronavirus. I'd much rather call it the Chinese virus, where it came from, than call it a thing that destroys a brand or destroys another company or destroys a business. So with that, it was the perfect year for that. I got to hang out with my amazing granddaughter from March till September when she started school, which is making me very sad. I'm not going to lie. I totally miss her and her energy and her excitement and just the joy that she brought to my life every day. And I am struggling a little bit to fill that void and to fix that. And it's amazing because I wasn't spending every day with her. Then all of a sudden I wasn't. It was so much fun and so amazing that I'm looking for ways to get that energy, keep that energy going in my life that don't involve, you know, having to hang out with her every day or getting to hang out with her every day. So that was the nerd part of the challenge today, was to act or share a way that you're a nerd. Now, some of us have been lifelong nerds. I mean, I've got ducks in a row all around me. If you look at my stuff around me, pure nerdiness, right? Pajama grandma. I showed up in my pajamas for 2 years online. So nerd doesn't scare me. I've been a nerd my whole life, and I'm actually cool with that, and I embrace that. And then overnight success was our topic and our idiom. No, it wasn't. Overnight success was our topic for Set Up for Success, which is the prep for the next 30-day Get Up and Go Challenge, which starts October 1st. October 1st through 31st, we'll do another 30-day free Get Up and Go Challenge. It helps people know what to do right now, no matter what their situation is. Equips them with an automatic mechanism or framework or process for dealing with any kind of change or challenge that pops up in their life that guarantees a better result after it than before they incurred or experienced that particular change or challenge or obstacle or setback or roadblock or whatever it is you want to call it. So that overnight success was the topic of the Setup for Success challenge. And it's not really a challenge. It's just what I'm doing in September between challenges, because I wanted to take part of a month off to go back and review the previous 30-day challenges or 40-day challenges we've done and pull out the best pieces of it so that it's always improving and getting better and better and better each time I do a challenge, because I want to make sure that I'm continuing to serve people at a higher level every time I do something. Even though it's got the same name, it's been a different challenge every time, which is what makes it fun and exciting, right? And the other thing is I always keep my challenges up. So if people want to go back and see any of the previous challenges and how it's evolved and get the bits and pieces and gold nuggets out of it, they're absolutely welcome to do that on, of course, in order on the Get Up and Go private group page, because it's in units and everything's in order versus actually going through it all backwards if you just go to the discussion feed on the page. So overnight success. One Horse Town was the topic of the Supersize Your Business idiom every day. And I started doing it, geez, 500 and some days ago, 565 days ago, but really longer than that, because I don't start counting things right away. It's like today is day 964, I think, of this challenge, but I don't even know how many videos I did or how many days I was doing online business and trying to figure stuff out online before I actually got online and started documenting my journey. It wasn't just 964 days ago. Again, not an overnight success, right? Had a lot of success, had a lot of failures, but I would never let anybody in any way, shape, or form about my life say I was an overnight success at anything. Everything that I've ever done in my life has required time, effort, work, learning, and been purposeful learning. It hasn't been just by accident or luck that I have stumbled into anything in my life. And I've had some really high highs and some really low lows, but all of it has come through effort, right? It wasn't just handed to me by anyone. And so I don't like it when people present themselves as overnight successes. Yeah, we all love a good rags to riches story, which is why I'm holding a bunch of rags in my lap. But it's not reality. It's not what really happened. It's like reading a novel or a book or seeing a show on television. We only see the highlights, right? We only see the points that are pertinent to the story. The same is true online. And one of my biggest ahas online was realizing that it's just marketing. It's just a story. Marketing is a story, and it's a story that's crafted out of the truth. Hopefully they're crafted out of the truth, but it's the bits and pieces of what happened in the truth that create the best story to present it to other people. It isn't what really happened, the nuts and bolts of what really happened. And any famous person, any expert, any person you see that's telling a story is telling the stories from their life that they choose to tell to attract and get the attention of and to reach the people that they're here to serve. That's all well and good, right? That's all fine and good. It's just some people manipulate the story more than is really ethical. Other people do a great job pulling out and telling the stories that attract the people that they really can serve and help. I can think of dozens and dozens of people that do that in a very ethical, amazing way. But then there's also thousands and thousands of inexperienced people that don't do it in an ethical way, that do it in a way to manipulate and just to serve themselves. I think of politicians. I think of some religious leaders. And there's leaders like this in every industry and every occupation on the planet. There's good and bad in everything, right? There's good and evil in absolutely everything. There's actually some good and evil in each one of us, whether we want to admit it or not, or whether we recognize it or not. Some of us, sometimes we have bad thoughts, right? Sometimes we have mean thoughts. Sometimes we have revenge thoughts. But that doesn't mean that we ever act on them. And of course, we try to stuff those down whenever we have them. But it's human nature when someone hurts us to get upset. It's human nature when somebody hurts our feelings or does something mean or evil toward us that we feel bad and we immediately have that, hey, stop, wait a minute, you can't do that reaction. And then usually we take a deep breath and we're like, okay, yeah, that just happened. What the heck? Now what do I do or how do I respond? And usually our reason kicks in before our emotions run away with us and we do the right thing. So overnight success, nerds, One Horse Town, Supersize Your Business, working on the book. But I got to admit, I've been really, really bad about working on the book this week. It's been a week of actually a lot of drama and weird energy coming from me personally and just feeling a little off this week. So some things that I wanted to get done haven't gotten done yet. And I say they haven't gotten done yet because usually whenever I've committed to myself to do something, I get a second wind and then I catch all up on it. Like someone challenged me to do 20 minutes a day on my book. And I've been working on a book for a while, but not really working on it. Been thinking I wanted to do it, but not really committed to it. So I said, okay, I'll do 20 minutes a day. Well, of course, beginning of the week, 2 days, family drama, stuff came up, didn't do it for 2 days. But then on Wednesday, I knocked out, you know, a couple hours on it. So then I made up for the 20 minutes that I missed the previous days. So I have this knack for finding a way to, once I made a commitment to myself, make sure I get it done before the deadline. So before the book's done, I guarantee I will have averaged 20 minutes a day working on it. So anyway, and we do that with life, right? We find different ways to look at things to make sure that we are being true to what's right for us. So any questions, any way I can help you, any, I guess, I don't know, anything I could do for you, any questions you're having that you don't know who else to ask, that you just want to say, hey, this is really blocking me, what the heck do I do? Hit me up in the comments below. I'll always say, I might not know the answer, but I do have an incredible group of people and resources at my fingertips that I can help find you the right person or resource or book or whatever you need to help you move that next step in the direction that you want to go. That's it. Have an awesome day, and I'll of course be with you tomorrow with what you up to now, letting you know what I'm doing as I document my journey of transition from the brick and mortar world, the corporate world, to the online world.